So wasn't that one of the best movies you've seen this year? Veteran is now the third most watched films in Korea of all times, with 13.4 million admissions. Were you surprised by this? What was your reaction when you?
감독님 사실 이 관객이 한국 관객이 이제 베테랑 그 관객 동원 수가 거의 한 1,300만 명 지금 넘어가고 있는 실정인데 이 이런 이제 엄청난 관객 반응 놀라셨는지.
일단 처음에는 왜 이렇게 많이 보지라는 생각이 들었었어요.
The first thought that came to my mind was like, why are so many people coming to see this film?
이번 영화를 만든 사람 영화를 만들 때 항상 많은 분들이 봐주셨으면 하는 생각으로 만들죠.
Of course, when you're making a film, you make it in the hopes of the fact that it'll reach a lot of audience members.
근데 저의 예상을 완전히 뛰어넘는 흥행이어서 많이 당황했었습니다.
But it was it was quite a striking result that completely went beyond my expectations.
한국에서 이렇게 흥행이 되는 영화들이 있는데 그 아주 큰 흥행을 한 영화들은 사실은 만든 사람들도 잘 분석을 못해요.
There, you know, there are certain hits in Korea, but like when these things happen, even like you know, trend analysts aren't really able to discern why that is.
어떠한 현상이고 사건이라고 생각합니다.
I guess it's more of like a phenomenon or an incident.
근데 아마도 돌이켜 보면 그 당시에 어떤 집단적인 무의식을 건드려 준 그런 것이 있는 것 같아요.
But when you look back in retrospect, I think those kinds of films that make it big in Korean among Korean audiences, I feel that they sort of touch on the unconscious collective mind. Of the Korean people in that time, or a zeitgeist, so to speak.
근데 좀 이제 시간이 지나고 나서는 그렇게 많은 관객이 들었다고 해서 제 인생이 크게 바뀌는 건 없는 것 같아요, 아직은.
But when you think about it, it's I don't feel that my life has changed drastically just because of the fact that so many people have come to see my film.
좋은 것은 이렇게 영화 흥행이 되고 나서 이렇게 뉴욕에 와서 여러분들을 만나는 이런 기회를 갖게 된다는 것이 좋은 점이고요.
I guess the pros of having a successful film in Korea is that I get to actually come abroad in like places like here in New York and get to meet audiences like you.
나쁜 점은 너무 많은 연락을 받아요.
The cons is that I am sought out by like everywhere, so that gets kind of tiring.
아무튼 빨리 이 시기를 흘려보내려고 하고 있습니다.
So in essence, I'm basically trying to sort of like let go of all this craze and buzz that's going on around me.
So you wrote the screenplay for the film. How did you develop the idea? And were there any true events that have happened in Korea that inspired some of the film?
이 영화를 각본을 쓸 때는 크게 두 가지 지점에서 출발을 했어요. 첫 번째는 제가 만든 전작들이 너무 어두웠고 등장인물이 패배하는 얘기였습니다. 그래서 제가 응원하는 주인공이 승리하는 모습을 좀 보고 싶었어요.
So when I was started to screenwrite for this screenplay, there were two points that I had in mind. The first was that my previous films had all dealt with very heavy subject matter, and they dealt with the subject of defeat. And so the next film that I wanted to work on was a film where a character I was rooting for actually won.
근데 이런 영화에서는 누가 싸우느냐도 중요하지만. 그 주인공이 누구와 상대하느냐도 되게 중요합니다.
But in films like that, I think it's important. It's important to see the characters, but also I feel like it's important to see the fact of who is fighting who in the film.
이 영화를 만들기 수년 전부터 제가 특정 재벌 권력 집단의 횡포 뭐 이런 것들에 좀 스트레스가 있는 상태였어요.
So a few years ago, I mean, even before conceiving this film, I was pretty much enraged about certain exploitative behavior that was being committed by large conglomerate companies in Korea.
권력을 가진 사람들이 자신이 힘이 있다는 이유만으로 사람이 사람에게 해서는 안 될 행동들을 하는 모습을 보면서 제가 좀 화가 많이 나 있었습니다.
So at the time, I was thinking that you know just because you're in a position of power doesn't give you the right to exploit someone or to treat a human being not like a human being. So I was really enraged in this kind of phenomenon that was happening in Korea at the time.
그래서 제가 만드는 영화 속에서라도 이기고 싶었어요. 승리하고 싶었어요.
So for myself, like I wanted to win over that kind of power. At least, just in my film, I wanted to win over that.
조금이라도 피해자들에게 위로가 되고 싶기도 했고요.
I wanted to become at least a little bit of a solace to the victims who were involved in these various real life events.
그리고 우리 스스로가 그런 부당한 것들에 대해서 저항해도 죽지 않는다는 모습을 좀 보여주고 싶었습니다.
And I wanted to show audience members that you know when you rise up against unjust behavior that you're not going to die. It's not going to kill you.
근데 이 영화에서 사실 본격적으로 다루는 이야기가 결코 가벼운 얘기는 아니죠.
But the incident that this film is dealing with is actually not such a very light subject. It's a pretty weighty subject.
그렇기 때문에 코미디라는 양념이 굉장히 중요했습니다.
So that is why bringing in the genre of comedy was important for this film.
어렵고 무거워질 수 있는 이야기를 쉽고 친절하게 표현하고 싶었어요.
It could become like a hard and complicated story, but I wanted the storytelling that I wanted to do, I wanted to do it in a more simpler and a more a nicer way.
그러려면 사건과 인물들에 대해서 제가 보다 더 명확하게 알고 있었어야 했습니다.
So in order to do that, it was imperative that I was very clear on what I wanted for the characters and the stories and the incidents involving the story.
그래서 굉장히 많은 사람들을 만나서 취재하는 데 많은 시간을 들였습니다.
So in order to achieve that, I took a lot of time to go through countless interviews to get that part right.
실제로 이 영화 속에 나오는 형사들의 행동과 말들은 실제로 제가 만났던 사람들이 쓰는 말과 행동들이에요.
So the lines that the detectives use in this film are actual words that real life detectives use in real life, and that comes from the interviewing phase, the research phase.
그리고 이 영화는 영화가 완성되기까지 계속해서 시나리오를 고치고 했습니다.
So, like even throughout the whole filmmaking process, I kept on rewriting the script.
사실 저뿐만이 아니라 모든 배우와 스태프들이 같이 만들어갔어요.
It wasn't just myself that was involved in the screenwriting process. Even the actors. And crew and staff members also chipped in this process as well.
베테랑을 만든 모든 사람들이 시나리오를 쓰고 상황을 연출했습니다.
So in a nutshell, like everyone involved in the making of Veteran, were also involved in the screenwriting process.
I think it's very interesting to look at who is the real bad guy in the movie, right? So. I think Yuan is kind of classic bad guy, but is he a victim of a circumstance? Is it really evil, or there are some other forces at play here?
Yeah, 그래서 여기 이 영화에서 진짜 악당은 누구인지에 대한 궁금증이 일어나는데요. 유아인 같은 경우는 이제 아 뭐 어떻게 보면은 굉장히 전통적인 악당이다라고 또 볼 수 있겠지만 혹은 유아인 또한 어떤 상황에 이제 떠밀려서 악당이 된 경우인지. 아니면 어떤 또 다른 어떤 네, 상황적인 영향을 받은 이제 어쩔 수 없는 악당인 것인지 그거에 대한 견해는 어떠신지?
기존의 경찰 액션 영화에서 보여지는 것과 가장 다른 지점이 이 영화 속의 악당의 묘사에 있다고 저는 생각을 합니다.
So I feel feel the difference between my previous detective-based films and this film is who the villain is in this film?
결정적으로 그 조태호라고 하는 악당은 자신의 범죄를 인지를 못해요.
The most crucial element about Jo-tae-ho, who is, you know, portrayed as a villain in this film, is that he is not conscious of the fact that he is committing serious crimes.
그렇다고 해서 이 인물이 사이코패스나 소시오패스는 아닙니다.
Not to say that this guy is a complete sociopath or a psychopath.
그냥 성장을 덜한 인물이에요.
He is simply a kid that hasn't grown up.
너무 많은 권력을 쥐어버린 어린아이인 거죠.
So because he was given so much power at an early age, he's just a power-wielding kid.
그는 책임질 필요가 없고 책임이라는 것이 뭔지도 잘 모릅니다.
He's never had to take responsibility for anything in his life, and because of that, he does not know what responsibility even means.
그냥 자기가 하고 싶은 대로 사는 인물이에요.
He's just a guy who does what he wants, basically.
그러다가 벌어지는 일들을 주변에서 처리해 주죠.
And so, if there are consequences that arise from his actions, the people around him are the people who just take care of things for him.
왜냐면 조태호의 가문 주변에서 기생하고 있는 인물들은 그가 무너지면 자신들도 무너진다고 생각하기 때문에.
And the reason for this is because the people who are around Jo-tae-ho, they are willing to do this because as parasites of him that live next to him, they know that they will not be able to survive if they are not willing to take care of his messes.
본질적으로 더 나쁜 인물은 그가 행하는 행동들이 범죄라는 것을 알고 있으면서도 그것을 저지르게 하고 그것을 감싸주려고 하는 인물들이겠죠.
So I feel like the real villain here is not Jo-tae-ho, who is not even aware of the fact that he's making these messes. I think it's the people who are actually very acutely aware of the fact that he is committing these crimes, but are willing to condone it or even cover it up.
각자의 이익을 위해서 개입하는 여러 인물들이 서로에게 작용하면서 그것은 일종의 시스템이 됩니다.
So when individuals try to go for their own goals and try to benefit themselves, that is when something called like a system, like a social system, is starting to emerge.
심지어는 그런 권력의 피해를 당하고도 아니 뭐 이 정도는 괜찮아 하고 외면하는 것조차 그 시스템의 일부라고 생각해요.
There are even cases where even when you've been a victim of exploitation from, you know, these people in power, there are people who say, well, you know, it wasn't too bad, and they just, you know, ignore it altogether. I feel like even behavior like this contributes to this sort of corruptive system.
저는 그렇게 정화작용이 안 되는 채 부패하는 시스템에 대해서 얘기하고 싶었습니다.
I wanted to talk about a system that is not self-cleansing, like this, a system that keeps on, that where corruption keeps on piling and piling up as a result of people just trying to survive in this sort of way.
이 영화에서 보면 사실 현실에서 가장 가까운 인물은 최성무일 것입니다.
So when you look at this film, I feel like the person that relates the most to an everyday man would be the Choi Sang-woo, who's yes.
먹고 살기 위해서 자신의 가족들을 위해서라는 이유로 어떤 이 부패를 덮고 이 정도면 괜찮아 하고 외면하곤 하는 모습이 우리와 가장 가깝다고 생각합니다.
So I feel like his behavior. He says that, you know, in order to protect his family or to survive or to, you know, provide for his family, even though he knows that corruption is going on, he condones it or even like actively ignores it. And I feel like that that sort of behavior is actually the most relatable and the most pervasive behavior that we are engaging in today?
어쩌면 저를 포함해서 아 저런 시스템이 문제야라고 손가락질하면서 사실은 문제의 본질을 해결하지 않으려고 그냥 외면해 버리는 우리 자신의 이야기이기도 할 것입니다.
I feel like this is a story that involves all of us. I think this is a story about ourselves, including myself. A story about you know, we can all complain and we can try and point fingers at the social system and say, you know, this is wrong and whatnot. But I feel that in essence, we are not doing an active, we are not playing an active role to actually put a stop to it, but just in a sense ignoring it.
We're gonna take some questions.